do like Lights Out. I like that song a lot.
So descriptive of her life with her father and of her feelings after his demise was, for me, the most personally evocative.
It was such an astonishingly poetic, kind of metaphoric way to talk about it. I thought it was elegantly done, and so it's my favorite. It may not be hers.
I mean, I've never capitalized on who I am in any way. I've never run around trying to make Presley perfume. I've never, I'm not that person instinctively. So a song that makes reference to that part of my life and who I am in that way, it's like, for me, it's a song for me. For others, it's that association of, oh, she's talking about Memphis in the grave, and the damn backyard, that's Graceland, and oh yeah, that's where her family's buried, and oh, that she's talking about their dad, and she's talking about Graceland in Memphis, and there it is. I can't, for me, it's just a song.
And she writes about it in Lights Out. She said, there's a spot there in the backyard for me. And I looked to my left, and there was this spot. People don't have a clue the weight. They don't have a clue the weight that she holds on these shoulders of hers, this little 5'3" blowhole that she is.
She woke up a different person at 13 years old, of which I never expected, and it does happen, and I wasn't quite prepared for it. She did dabble in drugs.
I find it very fascinating how people love to talk about how I had this drug problem. Let's just get into that now, because that is the most insane. Like, every time I read things and it's like, drug this, drug, trouble with drugs, she was this, she was that, you know? I had like a 2-year, 3-year period where I was experimenting when I was from 14, 15, 16. Normal, typical age range time period. I haven't touched a drug since any of that. Now, I'm 37 years old right now. Can we get over this?